The Fountaine Pajot New 44 was just announced in January 2025, and it's causing quite a stir in the sailing world. Why? Because it's one of the first production catamarans designed from the ground up to be fully electric. At $600,000, this isn't just another luxury catamaran. It's a bold statement about where sailing is headed. But is it worth the premium over traditional diesel power? Today, we'll analyze the specs, crunch the numbers, and find out if this could be the boat that changes everything. While we'll see the real thing in La Rochelle this July, what's been announced so far might surprise you. By the end of this review, you'll understand whether this could be the future of sailing or just an expensive experiment. And trust me, some of our findings might surprise you. What's out there? Sails up high. What's out there? Let's start with the basics. The new 44 is Fountaine Pajot's latest midsize catamaran, replacing their popular Elba 45. And yes, they really called it the new 44. After the Orana, Helia, and Elba, it seems they ran out of exotic names and went with, well, new. I guess when you're making something this revolutionary, you can keep it simple. But what makes this boat special isn't its straightforward name or its length or beam. It's what's under the hood. At the heart of this boat is the ODSea Plus electric propulsion system. We're looking at dual 25 kilowatt electric motors. That's roughly equivalent to twin 40 horsepower diesel engines in terms of thrust. Now, here's where it gets interesting. Compared to the diesel version, you're looking at about a 15% price premium. That's the $600,000 base price we mentioned. But what you get for that premium is fascinating. Instead of traditional engines, you've got a complete power management system. You get twin electric motors, large battery banks, 2,000 watts of integrated solar panels, a backup generator for extended range, and smart power management that ties it all together. Yes, it costs more upfront, but Fountaine Pajot is betting that the benefits of electric propulsion will outweigh that initial investment, and that's exactly what we're here to find out. Now, before we dive into the technical details, let's see what all this technology means in the real world. Let's start with harbor maneuvering. This is where electric power really shines. The instant torque from these electric motors gives you incredible control at low speeds. No more waiting for diesel engines to respond, just smooth, precise movements. And the best part? Complete silence. No more shouting over engine noise while docking. Out on the water, the experience is transformative. When you need motor assistance while sailing, there's no diesel rumble breaking the peace, just silent power when you need it. But the real magic happens when you're at anchor. Let's look at a typical day. Your fridge and basic systems use about 4 to 5 kilowatt hours. Air conditioning might add another 8 to 10 kilowatt hours. Entertainment and cooking add another 2 to 3. Here's where those 2,000 watts of solar panels earn their keep. In good conditions, they're generating about 12 kilowatt hours per day. That means you can run your basic systems indefinitely without ever starting the generator. Think about that for a moment. No generator noise, no diesel fumes, just the sound of waves and wind. It's a completely different anchoring experience. The smart power management system makes all this seamless. It automatically balances everything: solar input, battery storage, power consumption, and even hydrogeneration while sailing. Speaking of hydrogeneration, here's something fascinating. When you're sailing at good speed, the propellers can generate up to 4 kilowatts of power. That's enough to offset most of your power usage while underway. After living with this system, you start to think differently about power. It's not about having unlimited energy, it's about smart energy management. And in most scenarios, you'll never even need to think about it. Now that we've seen how this works in practice, let's dive deeper into the technical details. Let's start with the batteries. You have two options here. The standard setup gives you 42 kilowatt hours total capacity. Or you can go for the enhanced version with 54 kilowatt hours. Both use lithium iron phosphate chemistry, chosen specifically for its stability and longevity in marine environments. Now, let's talk real numbers. At cruising speed, here's what you're looking at. Power consumption runs at about 20 kilowatts. With the standard battery pack, that gives you about 2 hours and 45 minutes of range. The enhanced battery pushes that to 3 hours and 30 minutes. In actual distance, we're talking 12 to 18 nautical miles. But here's where it gets interesting. The 24 kilowatt generator isn't just a backup. It's an integral part of the system. When it's running, it can fully offset your cruising power needs. it consumes about 6 to 7 liters per hour. And with 700 liters of fuel capacity, that gives you about 130 to 140 hours of runtime. The smart energy management system constantly balances multiple sources. You've got solar input of up to 2 kilowatts, hydro generation up to 4 kilowatts while sailing, generator power of 24 kilowatts when needed, plus your battery storage and consumption. In real-world conditions, mixing these power sources, the numbers get really interesting. You're looking at potential ranges of 800 nautical miles with conservative use. That can stretch up to 1,500 nautical miles with optimal sailing conditions. And at anchor with good solar conditions, you could theoretically stay out indefinitely. But numbers only tell part of the story. To understand why this matters, we need to look at the bigger picture. The marine industry is at a turning point, with environmental regulations tightening worldwide. More and more popular cruising grounds are implementing strict emission controls. We're seeing this in Mediterranean harbors, Scandinavian fjords, and California coastal waters. And this trend is only accelerating. This is why Fountaine Pajot's move is so significant. The new 44 isn't just replacing the Elba 45. It's redefining what a production catamaran can be. Let's look at the evolution. Back in 2019, the Elba 45 launched with traditional diesel power. By 2022, we saw the first hybrid experiments. And now in 2025, the new 44 debuts as a fully electric-focused design. This isn't just about being green. It's about future-proofing. As regulations continue to tighten, boats like the new 44 will be ready, while others may face restrictions or costly retrofits. But how does this compare to what other manufacturers are doing? Let's take a look at the competition. Let's look at its closest rival, the Leopard 46. Leopard's approach is fundamentally different. They've gone with what's called a parallel hybrid system. It can switch between electric and diesel power, but it's limited to 1,000 watts of solar. It also has a smaller battery capacity and uses a more traditional power management approach. In the 43 to 46 foot range, we're seeing different strategies from each manufacturer. Lagoon's 43 focuses on comfort with traditional power. The Nauticek 44 emphasizes performance with lighter displacement. Bali's 4.4 maximizes living space. And then there's the new 44, making a full commitment to electric power. This actually reminds me of the early days of electric cars. Remember the Chevy Volt versus early Teslas? The Volt took a hybrid approach, while Tesla went all in on electric. But thus, let's look at its closest rival, the Leopard 46. Leopard's approach is fundamentally different. They've gone with what's called a parallel hybrid system. It can switch between electric and diesel power, but it's limited to 1,000 watts of solar. It also has a smaller battery capacity and uses a more traditional power management approach. In the 43 to 46 foot range, we're seeing different strategies from each manufacturer. Lagoon's 43 focuses on comfort with traditional power. The Nauticek 44 emphasizes performance with lighter displacement. Bali's 4.4 maximizes living space. And then there's the new 44 making a full commitment to electric power. Now, let's talk about what keeps potential buyers up at night. The biggest concern? Range anxiety. What happens when you're fighting against tide and wind and your battery is down to 20%? Well, Fountaine Pajot has thought about this carefully. They've built in multiple redundancies to keep you safe. The backup generator can run continuously. The solar panels provide a constant trickle charge. You can generate power while sailing. And you've got multiple charging options when you're in port. Let's talk about the elephant in the room. Long-term costs. You'll need to replace the batteries every 8 to 10 years. Generator maintenance is similar to what you'd expect with traditional diesel. The solar panels should last 20 plus years. But here's the upside. You'll spend a lot less on engine maintenance. But what about challenging conditions? The system is designed to handle everything from strong headwinds to adverse currents, extended periods without sun, and even emergency situations. Looking to the future, there are some significant advantages. You'll be compliant with future regulations. You might save money on carbon taxes. While diesel prices keep rising, electricity costs tend to stay more stable, and battery technology just keeps getting better and better. So, after diving deep into the new 44, here's our verdict. This isn't just another electric boat. It's a glimpse into the future of sailing. The advantages are clear. You get silent operation, zero emissions capability when you want it, a future-proof design, smart power management, and multiple power sources working together. But yes, there are challenges. There's that higher upfront cost. You'll need to think about battery replacement down the line. You'll need a different mindset when it comes to planning your power usage. And pure electric range is still limited compared to diesel. So, who is this boat for? It's perfect for weekend sailors who want the latest tech. It's great for environmentally conscious cruisers. It's ideal for island hopping in sunny conditions. And it makes a lot of sense for anyone planning to keep their boat for 10 years or more. Looking ahead, this approach to electric propulsion isn't just a trend. It's the beginning of a transformation in sailing. As battery technology improves and regulations tighten, boats like the new 44 will become more common, not less. If you found this analysis helpful, please hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell. We're just getting started with our in-depth looks at the latest in sailing technology. Drop a comment below with what boat you'd like us to analyze next. And if you're interested in learning more, check out Fountaine Pajot's full presentation in the description below. Thanks for watching, and until next time, fair winds and following seas.